Welcome to today's video, guys. Unfortunately, it is my last day at the compound. My buddy DJ's with me. We're just cruising around, having a good time. Can you hold this for me?
Yes,
for a
I can.
It's a bit hard. I don't want to
crash.
I don't want to vlog and drive at the same time. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Why, DJ? I nearly killed myself. That was bad.
I was not expecting him to do that.
Don't go on the grass.
Oh, okay. Did you really almost just fall, or was that
I nearly cracked, that was a bad idea. I didn't realize I was going that far, so I'm never doing that again. I don't know how LZ does that. Jeez.
at least it wasn't a lake.
I was hoping for a little, yeah, at least we didn't end up in that. I should have sent you into that. That would have been funny. Anyways, I learned a lesson. I'm never doing that again. Today's my last day at the compound. My last day in Florida. The weather's really nice today. Like, it's hoodie weather, but the sun's out. It's perfect. Before we leave though, I think it's very important we do a little bit of shopping. Pretty fortunate that the Drift HQ guys are all here and they have a bunch of stuff in stock, including PRP stuff, Plasma Man stuff. So without trying to give away too much, there's a few things that these guys have that I need for some builds that are about to get underway back home. So what I can show you guys are some of the dress up parts that we're going to be getting. First of all, we're just going to get some lug nuts because you can never have enough steel, decent quality lug nuts. These are the GK Tech ones. These ones are actually really good. Look at these, beautiful. Never get the alloy ones. And then we're going to get some PRP stuff. I love that I can just come up on the shelves and pick some stuff. So we're going to get some dress up kits. I think I'm going to go with black. PRP, please start making pink. Just please do it. You will sell a lot of them, I promise. I don't know for a fact, but I'll definitely be buying a lot. We're going to definitely get some RB ones. The Mac mounts, the Mac port valves. Yeah, not enough companies make brackets for those. All right. I'm going to keep shopping and just kind of pick anything and everything off the shelf that I want. So I got everything that I needed that I can actually fit in my suitcase. The rest of it, we're going to have to get shipped home. But luckily, these guys got good shipping rates for international stuff, so we should be good. Perfect person I want to see. Can you give me a lift to the big bay shed?
Sure.
All right.
We can do that.
Yeah. Scoot over.
Yeet, yeet.
Today's video is sponsored by Dafsky, and if you don't know who they are an online store that sell air fresheners for your car. They have an absolutely massive range, so I'm gonna go through here right now. My K-Van's been kinda smelling a little funky lately, or maybe one of these ones. You know what, the pokey, oh wait, is that a taco one? Yes! We got this little guy out of his package, and oh, that smells so good. And just like that, now the K-Van is gonna smell good. So head to Dafsky.com and grab yourself some air fresheners for your ride. They're super affordable, massive range, and they always have those really cool little quirky characters and stuff like that that I'm sure all of you guys are gonna love. So once again, Dafsky, thank you for sponsoring today's video, and let's get back to it. Now before we leave, something special is going down. Waiting for those lights. We gotta grab a car from here. I have yet to ever ride or been in or drive a Porsche. And Adam just told me to jump in this and bring it. Bear with me for 5 minutes while I figure out how to turn this on. That's not a key, that's the shifter. Huh. Help? How does this turn on? Where's the stop button? Here? Oh, the seat moved. There's music playing. I thought that was a light switch. Oh, it wants to know like language and stuff. Okay, hang on. This? What gear am I in? We're in drive? We're moving. Okay, first Porsche experience. Yee yee. Got the Porsche outside now, about to close up, but damn man, dreams and goals all here. But I gotta ask the question, which would you guys pick out of this collection? The 34 or one of the Porsches.
Time to put some seatbelts on.
Always.
Adam's a little bit busy with meetings for the rest of today, so we got Mike with us.
What's up?
All right, Mike, apparently you can teach me everything that I need to know about how to drive this thing.
Yeah, so she's a little bit terrifying, but she's a river. This thing is, this is probably the fastest car that Adam has here in terms of launching.
Don't tell me that, I'm scared.
It's like you can feel the insides of yourself like hit the back of the seat. It's it's a ripper, but yeah, I can show you how to run through everything. This thing's nuts.
All right, well, I struggled to turn this thing on. I looked for a good minute for the power button. I thought this was the headlight button over here first.
You'd think that it'd be here or here.
Yeah. I was like looking for like a red button or something.
It takes a few minutes.
Yeah, cool. All right, well, Mike's gonna run me through some stuff. I'm gonna probably take it for a little bit of drive, and then I might get Mike to give me a drive because he's gonna be way more comfortable in the seat because he's driven it a bunch.
Yeah.
So we should be good. But the yellow stitching is amazing. I'll dig in that.
It's a good touch.
Yeah. It matches with your hat. That's actually epic right now.
All right, it's time.
Yep, we're in Sport Plus mode, I just learned. So I'm not gonna touch the paddles. I'm just gonna hold the brake down with my left foot, right?
Yep.
Hold. And then throttle all the way to the ground?
Yep, and then wait for launch mode activated to come up there, and then drop the brake.
Oh boy.
All right.
Tell me when.
Go.
Okay.
Any day now.
What?
It's terrible.
Wait, new cars can do that?
Yeah, dude.
Selling all of my Japanese cars.
Dude.
That felt insane.
I've been in this car so many times, it still makes me shake every time this thing launches.
Oh my god.
It's terrifying, dude.
The crazy thing is it doesn't even feel like you're going fast in the driver's seat.
Yeah.
I bet the passenger feels insane.
You get rocked.
Okay, I kind of want to make you do that, but I don't want to like how many... Does this, like, damage it or anything doing launches?
Not really. It'll, like, you know, obviously it's not the best for the car, but it's set up for it, so. I think this is around, like, 750 all-wheel horsepower.
Dude, that felt insane. Like, there was wheels, like, slipping and stuff, but it all controlled everything.
Yeah.
That felt like I was cheating. Like, it felt like I'm not supposed to be allowed to be able to do that.
Yeah, that's what Adam says. This feels like you have everything unlocked on GTA. And no race is fair.
But it doesn't even feel dangerous. That's the scary thing.
It's planted and just a solid car.
Okay. All right. I want to jump in the passenger seat and feel that if you're okay doing
that for me. Yeah, I'm down.
That is... Wow. I've never experienced anything like that in my life.
Look at that. He spun him.
Whew. Lining up again.
That's insane. You can actually see everything while you're recording. I didn't notice that before. All right, so I'm gonna be in the passenger seat this time. Putting my seatbelt on. One thing that kind of throws me off though is like, what's with this? It's kind of a bit weird, no?
Yeah, that was like, Adam doesn't like it either. He wishes that he could just get rid of it altogether.
Yeah.
But.
Oh well. All right.
Go. Dude, I haven't done this in so long. I'm shaking too.
Oh boy. All right, hang on. Let me turn and face this, because. I want to know what this is like.
All right,
here we go.
Dude. The passenger experience is unlike anything I've experienced. My camera's struggling because of the lighting. But like, what? I've never been scared like that. Dude, I've never been scared like that.
This thing, man. Is terrifying. It's terrifyingly good.
That's ridiculous. It's an entirely new experience in the passenger seat. Wow. Okay. Whoa. Feels so weird. It feels like everything was a lie to me about JDM cars. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Now I'm like, I want a Porsche. Whoa. Okay, that's Mm-hmm.
My heart just keeps beating. My whole body is shaking every time I like do stuff like this in this park.
I don't really know what to say.
It leaves you speechless.
It does.
It really does.
I don't even want to know what this is like just going from a launch to top speed. It would feel insane.
Yeah. I don't want to be in the car for that.
Yeah, could you imagine ripping this on like the Nürburgring?
I mean, yes. It'd be insane, but it'd be terrifying.
Yeah. Wow.
Especially as a passenger.
For sure. All right, I think we're going to go take this out for like just a little cruise on the road and stuff, but this is an insane car.
Nope.
All spin.
Nope. Nope.
Dude, it's crazy, man.
It puts like... Oh my gosh. I can't imagine what it would be like being a passenger. Like, this would be so scary. Like, imagine like never being in anything this fast before or like at all and just being thrown in the passenger seat and then like the guy just ripping on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a really cool car. It drives so smooth. And throttle response feels great. Yeah, I'm not gonna obviously rip it. I don't wanna break the law, but like, geez, this is so nice. I kinda wanna do it.
Thing is, it's like the fastest car on the road anywhere, and then it's also the comfiest.
Yeah. This is like, you could cruise for this and not have a single problem.
Yeah, it checks off the boxes.
Really nice.
Here we go, last pull.
Okay. Doesn't even feel like you're going fast.
Insane, dude.
Feels so good.
Sorry, cut your head off a little there. Trying to keep it exposed for inside.
This thing is amazing. Yeah, I can imagine myself getting in a lot of trouble with one of these in Japan.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It also makes a lot of sense why the guys in these kinds of cars in Japan fly past me at like 200 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're just meant to live there, I feel. It's like these cars were built for like the Autobahn and stuff, right?
Yeah.
And like those guys literally are driving like 200 miles an hour. So I'm not surprised that they feel this good. Like just the control. Like I've never driven a Skyline or an S chassis that drives and feels that good at high speeds.
Yeah.
It's just, it doesn't happen. So that's incredible. All right, well, I'm gonna just cruise really softly back to the compound. I'm gonna park this where I got it. And yeah, I'm not putting my foot down ever again in this.
We are now back in Connecticut, guys, and what an incredible trip. I just want to say and make it well known right now, like just thank you so much to Adam and everything that he did and his team and everything like that to want to accommodate me and just their hospitality and everything that went down like for the invitational and all that kind of stuff. It is an absolute honor and a privilege to be invited to that, to drive for that, to meet all of you guys. It felt so good to meet some of you guys in person and, you know, just give back to some of you that have been watching for so long. And yeah, I don't know, it was a very humbling experience, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. And I enjoyed every moment of that event. I never had a drift event that felt that way. Kind of reminiscing a little bit there, but obviously I also really look up to Adam, and it's just so good to hang out with him, get advice from him, and just obviously observe and see how he does things, because that's definitely where I want to be at, if that makes sense. And I think, like, for everyone, even you guys out there, you should always have that person you look up to, always have that mentor and stuff like that. And it's just always really, really good to spend time with him. That's all I'm trying to say. I miss him, and I hadn't seen him in a fair few years now, and it was such a good catch up. Anyways, that aside, guys, we're back in CT. I'm hoping in the next few days that we're going to be able to go to Tommy's shop and Chris's shop and do some work on the Jeep, fix the stuff that we broke. It's quite late right now, and I'm at a random Airbnb until tomorrow. But things are kind of hectic. And obviously with Chris's situation and stuff like that, I need to try and work out what we can and can't do. But from now, guys, we're back in Connecticut. We'll see what happens. I'll give you an update in the next video. You're going to have to tune in for that. Thank you so much for watching. Smash that like button, write a comment, and subscribe. That Porsche was insane, and it's changed my thinking perspective a lot on cars. Maybe the next purchase. I don't know. But guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Peace. Jamata. I need sleep.